The Block V Tomahawk is an upgraded version of the iconic missile, featuring improved navigation systems, an extended range, and a modular payload that makes it adaptable for a variety of strike missions. Its enhanced accuracy and ability to operate in a networked environment make it a highly flexible weapon, capable of targeting both land-based and maritime threats with precision. This flexibility is critical in today's fast-evolving conflict zones, where a missile's ability to adapt to different mission sets can make a difference in a rapidly changing operational environment. As regional security dynamics shift, and as more nations seek to boost their defensive posture, the Tomahawk remains one of the most powerful tools in the arsenal of the U.S. military and its partners. The ongoing modernization of the U.S. military and its allies' arsenals signals a continued emphasis on long-range, high-precision strike capabilities. With the threat of large-scale conflict in regions like the Indo-Pacific becoming more plausible, systems like the Tomahawk are essential for providing both deterrence and tactical flexibility. The report added that the destroyers currently under construction have experienced substantial delays to date. Just one Flight III destroyer, the USS Jack Lucas DDG-125, has been commissioned, and the keel was laid for the second Flight III. The future USS Lewis H. Wilson Jr. DDG-126 in 2023. Inside Defense reported in June that other Flight III vessels could see 6 to 25-month delivery delays. The Flight III configuration is considered critical to Navy warfighting on the high seas going forward. It will feature the INSPY-6V1 Air-N missile defense radar, as well as upgraded electrical power and cooling capacity, among other enhancements. Flight IIIS will also take on the Air Warfare Command ship mission currently handled by the Navy's aging and shrinking Ticonderoga-class cruiser fleet, which the Navy has been steadily retiring in recent years. Meanwhile, the Navy's next-generation destroyer, dubbed DDG-X, is facing its own cost increases and delays. The CBO found, while the Navy is believed to still be refining its core requirements for the ship class, TWZ has reported in the past about that platform. The Navy's 2025 shipbuilding plan called for production of those ships to commence in 2032, but the Navy later informed the CBO that the first ship actually WOULDNT begin production until 2034 or later. The Navy wants to eventually buy 28 DDG-X ships at an average cost of $3.3 billion per ship, a price driven mostly by an increase in the size and capabilities of the future warship, which would include a larger hull, more stealth capabilities, more power, and a greater capacity to accommodate future systems, according to the CBO. But given the size and new tech on board the DDG-X, CBO's assessment states that those ships will actually cost $4.4 billion on average. All told, the CBO report highlights several other challenges in American shipbuilding, as well as budgetary uncertainties, that could impact the Navy's ability to field a 390-ship battle force fleet by 2054. The fleet currently stands at 295 ships, while China's fast-growing naval force numbers more than 370 vessels. The Pentagon warned last month that the People's Liberation Army-Navy plan is increasingly building ever more capable warships and support ships that are enhancing the fleet's global reach. to hit that 390 ship target. The CBO found that new shipbuilding would cost $40 billion annually, 17% more than the Navy's estimates. CBO attributed the gap to the fact that the Navy DIDNT factor costs for refueling nuclear-powered vessels, outfitting new ships after delivery, or purchasing used sealift vessels, all of which are typically funded via the Navy's shipbuilding account. There have been long-standing questions about the viability of the Navy's long-term shipbuilding plans, particularly when it comes to not only building the fleet, but sustaining it.